There's alarm over proposed Cook Island legislations drafted by a private US-based company validating hacking into any account or system in the world. The tainted cryptocurrency recovery bill has far-reaching and serious international implications. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever has been investigating how it could affect the Cook Islands' constitutional relationship with New Zealand.
Cook Islands politicians arriving for a select committee meeting. The focus of attention, the tainted cryptocurrency recovery bill, drafted in secrecy by US company Drumcliff. Inside Parliament, the Crown lawyer tells the committee it's flawed, unconstitutional, and essentially validates carrying out what amounts to criminal activities worldwide. The private sector too having their say.
We have deep concerns with this particular bill in its current form. There are national security issues for us. There are constitutional issues. There are reputational issues.
The bill would allow agents to hack into any account they suspect could have cryptocurrency used for illegal means, and seize it. Eventually, it'd be turned into cash and assets deposited into a Cook Islands bank account. The bill would allow the installation of spyware to monitor possible future transactions.
I see this as maybe right out of a spy film type of thing. At first, I thought that it couldn't really be real. I thought that a lot of what's contained in the bill doesn't make sense, particularly with respect to cryptocurrency.
Drumcliff has an equity stake in Odyssey Marine Exploration, a company which is involved in deep sea mining exploration in the Cook Islands. Its principal, James Little, told One News that his company's interested in an ongoing role if the legislation goes through. He says his legal team's confident that the bill is fully compliant with the Cook Islands constitution and domestic and international laws. He claims seizing criminal proceeds makes the Cook Islands a good global citizen. International experts disagree.
The thing that concerns me is that there seems to be a conflict of interest here. The private actor's drafted the legislation and then he's going to act on it. And it just seems to be something which, on the face of it, completely inconsistent with the rule of law internationally.
Adding to his concerns, the Cook Islands is a realm country of New Zealand.
It does have implications for New Zealand's governance arrangements. New Zealand may have to reconsider its relationship with the Cook Islands.
Leaving the nation to answer serious questions.
Barbara is here with more on this. Barb, how can a private company have so much influence in the Cooks? Have you heard from the government there, the Prime Minister there?
Yes, well, we did put questions to the Prime Minister several days ago. Now, he didn't reply. However, this morning, a media release went out titled Cook Islands Gears Up to Fight Cybercrime. The Prime Minister, Mark Brown, says that the bill is still at select committee, and he says any bill that's passed will be within the constitution and also comply with international law. Now, remember that Crown Law told the select committee that the bill as it stands doesn't do any of those things. In fact, it's so badly flawed it needs to go back to the drawing board and not drafted by Drumcliff lawyers. Drumcliff, we also sent questions to, Melissa, and they're very, very keen to keep their name out of the public eye. In fact, we were told that naming them could put lives at risk because of security issues, but they weren't able to substantiate that. So certainly we've been left with more questions than answers about why Drumcliff, the reason why Drumcliff has chosen the Cook Islands to get this legislation passed.
Any response from our government?
Yes, so Winston Peters' office says it's tracking the legislation and Cook Islands officials are in discussion with New Zealand officials. I can tell you after decades of covering the Pacific that New Zealand will be extremely concerned about this, and we absolutely should be. A UK lawyer has called it state-endorsed cyber piracy. It puts a target on the Cook Islands' back, and if it puts a target on the Cook Islands' back, it puts a target on New Zealand's back because it's in free association with New Zealand. Now, there's a lot more on this story, Melissa, on onenews.co.nz.
Tēnā te mihi atu. Thank you very much, Barb.